Are you so disappointed that you would consider, let's say she got the nomination, you might vote for McCain?
Well, absolutely not. No. So I said,
couldn't go that far.
No, that's over the edge. I said in the same letter that most people I know are just going to stagger into the voting booth in November and look for the big D on the ballot. And it really isn't going to matter what the name is on there, whether
it's... You think the Democrats going to win?
People, 81% of the public says that we're on the wrong track. We've been through 8 years of misery, and it's not just the war, although that should be enough right there, but it's everything from what people are paying for gas now to our whole healthcare mess and everything else in this country that is just, we've lost so much time. I mean, when you saw last week that they're limiting how many bags of rice you can take out of Costco, I mean... I mean, that's the first sign that something here has gone seriously awry.
Don't you think, Michael, that the Democrats, though, they're the one party that can figure out a way to lose this?
Well, yeah, I mean, it's I understand that, and but it's not about the Democratic Party. This is going beyond that. That's what's so great about Obama, is that he's not a partisan person in that way, and that's why so many people, I mean, Julie Nixon endorsed him. Julie Nixon is for Obama. Michael Moore is for Obama. That, I think, explains the breadth of the support that he has in this country.
Do you think the Reverend Wright thing is over?
It's over when cable news decides it's over. When these networks come up with something new. I mean, I was enjoying the flag lapel controversy. By the way, Larry, where is your flag lapel pin? I don't see it on you.
Where's yours?
Huh? Well, I'm wearing mine. It's right. It's the world's smallest flag lapel pin.
Oh, I see.
You just can't see it.
Microscopic.
That's why you don't wear a coat, so you don't have to wear the flag lapel
pin. So you found me out.
Yeah, that's right. We'll put that in with your videotape of your rabbi, your former rabbi, I mean.
Do you expect or fear that Reverend Wright might start making other media appearances? Like he says, tit for tat, you said this about me, I'm coming back at you.
Well.
Possible.
Well, yeah, I guess it's possible.
And then we run with it.
Well, I hope you run the same the speeches from the minister that supports John McCain, who said that the Catholic Church was the whore of Babylon, and the other things that he said. I mean, there seems to be so much attention on the things that Reverend, and what did Reverend Wright say? He said that we were a nation founded on genocide and built on the backs of slaves. Any disagreement there? that was the essence of his speech. And he chose words and said things that I wouldn't say, Senator Obama wouldn't say, you wouldn't say. But it's a free country. He said it. But we're not voting for Reverend Wright. we're trying to get ourselves off 8 years of a Bush-McCain era that has driven this country deep, deep, deep down.
Well, it may not have damaged them as much as we may have thought it did.
Well, I don't think it has, and I would hope that Senator Clinton hope that this somehow plays to the worst in people's fears, especially white people. I hope that she will maintain her.
We'll see. In January, you posted a website letter that had good things to say about Obama's win in Iowa, but you also wrote this: Barack, you can talk all you want about let's put the partisanship aside, let's all get along. But the other side has no intention of being anything but the bullies they are. Get your game face on now. And if you can, tell me why you are now the second largest recipients of health industry payola after Hillary. Mm-hmm. Are you saying that's what he's getting, the industry?
Yeah, and I believe actually in that time since I wrote that in January, it's flipped. And he's now number one, at least with
in she's, funds from the
she
health.
She has one. She's number one, I think, with the pharmaceutical companies, and he's number one with health insurance, or vice versa. I can't remember what, but they're one and two in terms of.
Do you think if you take, you must be beholden to them? That's what Ralph Nader used to say. If I take too much, then I'm beholden to you.
Well, yeah, I think anybody understands that's the way the game is played. Well, that's why neither Senator Obama or Senator Clinton's health care plans will bring real universal health coverage to this country, because they both allow the insurance companies to still control what's going on. You have to remove the private profit-making health insurance companies, because as long as they have to make a profit, that means they can't take care of everybody in the same way, or they won't make the money they need to make. You have to remove profit as a motive just as you, it's one of those basic services. We wouldn't have a police department that had to show a profit every year, or a fire department that had to show a profit every year. We shouldn't do that with our health care system either, and no other Western country does that.
You think health is a right?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, it's a human right. And it really is everywhere else except, unfortunately, here.
With Michael Moore, more reaction to the latest Hillary Clinton interview when we come back.